Dear Thomas, I now understand why you declined my hand in marriage. It was immature of me to demand that you stop your life pursuits just to watch time pass by with a dumb country boy like me. I have returned home to Raven's Hollow, and in this time I have grown stronger in ways I never thought myself possible. I have my own life path now, and while it breaks my heart to know I will never see you again, I think you would be proud of my newfound purpose. You are my last connection to this world, and I wanted to give you one final goodbye. Farewell, Thomas. You are the one beautiful thing I ever found in this cruel world, and I wish I could drown in those blue eyes just one last time. Love always, William. P.S. Don't come looking for me.
dares interrupt our service to God. What do you want, outsider? I'm afraid you've come to our town during a time of cleansing. The last souls with blood untainted by the fruit stand before you. He isn't on the pile of smoldering corpses, if that's what you mean. You could try his house. It's located on the opposite side of the valley. That is, if you can even make it that far. There is a billboard by the main gate that will show you the way. If you get lost, simply remember that the windmill faces the town, and the rear faces the Forester property. Outsider, before you leave, take this rifle. It belonged to Abraham Walters, and as you can see, he is no longer in need of it. Well, once you get outside the church, be sure to take the time to put at least one bullet in the chamber. That way, if things get dire, you can at least shoot yourself. Be careful, outsider. Beyond that gate is a land rife with sin. May the Lord have mercy on your soul.
Thank you. Cool. So. So. Rah. Rah. Gone. gone. Ra. Zo. Gone. So, cool. Gone. In.
chest. I can't breathe. Thomas? Is that really you?
It really is you.
I don't recognize those blue eyes anywhere. I'm sorry, Thomas. I really wanted to tell you. But saying you were joining an ancient race of Farm's Face, not the son of Pigsaw, he's a good letter. Wait, how can you understand the words I am saying? I lost the ability to speak English some time ago.
No, no, no! Thomas, you should not have! This knowledge is forbidden to mortals!
Even French?
I'm dying, Thomas. The words you recited are only bought in a small amount of time. Look at you, saving me yet again. It pains me to say it, Thomas, but I need fresh, untainted blood. No, I need much more. This tree seems to have drained me. Now I honor all my life forms.
Where are you?
Wait, no.
No.
You've done well to lead us here. Now step aside and let us finish this. What you have found is not William. Look around you. Look at the soil. Look at the trees. Look at my people. This land has become infected, a seething rot that only fire can cleanse. All you need to do is walk away. I don't want any more bloodshed. Please, outsider. You can walk away, it's not too late. Kill the
outsider! Gone in.
Outsider! I know you're in there. Come out with your weapons down. You've done well to... Kill the outsider!
You've done well to...
Thomas strolled through the carnage he had wrought, blood seeping through the mud and leaves, forming a web of crimson. In the center of the gore, he found Sister Pyrus. She lay on her back, gasping in short, sharp breaths. Malice filled her eyes as Thomas came into view. She tried to mouth something, instead yielding to a bout of wet coughing. Thomas gazed skyward to the rolling storm clouds. He gripped his axe tightly until his knuckles glowed white. He felt his eyes begin to well with tears, but caught himself in the final moments, drawing a deep breath, and with it, new resolve. He wrenched the nun by the ankle and began dragging her back to the den, while she wheezed and spluttered in protest. My William, my love, my eternal star, I will never lose you again.
Now, it's an older model, but it should make short work of those chains. Shit. Better restart the generator.
there, Hera. It's your mother. I'm sorry for not reaching out sooner. I was just so angry at Claudia, and you two seem to be doing just fine without me, so... Oh, that's not fair. She was always the better mom, and I just wanted to keep you away from all of this, but I guess I fucked that up too. I need your help. I had a patient, and if I had just seen the signs earlier, he caused the breach. Look, I know you hate me, trust me. I wouldn't be reaching out like this if I didn't need you, and for what little it's worth now, I do need you.
Hey, doesn't she go by Artemis now?
What? Oh, for... Good job, Sam. Mother of the year again.
Damn it, Sam. No one's called me Hera since... Come to think of it, it was you. When I was 15. God, I was so mad. It took me hours to clean up those plates I smashed. Is that why you stopped calling me? I've uncovered some information that points to the cause of the breach. It seems something that Dr. Crane and her team were working on broke containment. Which really just takes the cake, doesn't it, Mom? Your work was always so much more important than us. And for what? To fuck everything up? Not just for us, but for everyone? Gods, it's just so fucking perfect. Whatever. I shouldn't be recording this.